Hi guys! In this tutorial I will teach you a fast way to draw this front elevation of the floor plan I was making in the previous videos. It's very simple and will match the view of this side of the floor plan with the main door and two windows. So I'm going to start drawing, and in order to help you following this lesson, you can watch in this corner the different sections I will be drawing. So first, I will start drawing the outline of the ground floor with the command line. I will type L for activating the command line. Then I will draw the first horizontal line, which is 8500. Then the vertical line, which is 2760. And after the upper horizontal line, which is again 8500. And for the last one, I can just click in this endpoint to connect here. Now, the next step is these two parallel lines, which I'm going to use the command offset. I'm going to type O, or I can click in its icon in the ribbon there. Then I will type the offset distance, which is 80. I click on the line. And then I move the pointer up and click again. For the second line, as it is the same distance, I can click in the line I just created, as the command is still active, and click once more. As you see, these two lines were very fast to draw. Now we will proceed with the elevation of the roof. So, as before, I will use line to draw all the border following the dimensions you can find in the PDF file. I will start with this horizontal line, which is 20, and then is this vertical one, which is 50. And if you have this label here that says polar, you can type now the value to have a perfectly vertical line. So we continue with the following lines. For this one at the top, the distance will be 8500 plus 2 times 20, which is the value of the two tiny lines at each side. Then, for this vertical is again 3000. And finally remains the 50 vertical and 20 horizontal. The last one will match that point if everything was drawn correctly. For the lines of the roof, I can use again the offset. Now my first distance will be 50. Press enter. I select the line. Now I offset it there. For all the other lines, they have a constant spacement between them of 200. So I will type that distance. Then I select the line. And I am going to type M for multiple. With this operation, I will be able to place with a simple click several lines with the distance I specified before. So, as you see, it's so simple. Then, what you don't want anymore, you just press enter. Now I want to show you something I didn't do it well. If I zoom in, I can see that the lines don't go to the extremity. This happened because I didn't offset the two tiny lines that measure 20. However, I will solve this quite fast using the command extend. For that, I'm going to type EX and press enter. First, I have to select the objects which I want to act as the boundary. In my case, those two lines. I press enter. And only then I select the lines I want to extend. It's everything to the top. Press enter. And as you see, I extended the line so easily. On the next part, I'm going to show you all the process to draw this door. First of all, I am going to draw the frame, starting with the first line at the bottom. I'm going to activate the command line. I click in a point. And now I'm going to type the distance, which is 900. After I press escape, because now I'm going to use the command polyline. I type PL and I'm going to draw the external border of the frame. Then the next distance, I'm going to insert 900 again. And finally, just connect with the point I've started. So here you can see the polyline consisting of the last three lines I've drawn. For the next step, I'm going to use the command offset and I will apply it to the polyline. I will type for the distance 70 as it's in the file. Press enter. I click in the polyline and I click again inside the door. The frame is completed. Now I am going to show you a technique to draw the door detailing in a fast way. But of course, there are several ways to do it that work well. First, I will use the command line. I hover the pointer over the endpoint, then I drag up. And when I see the label extension, I will type the distance of 250. Now I can draw this line. To reach the point, I'm going to start the first rectangle. I press escape and then I will use the command rectangle. Even I can still use polyline here, with this one I need less steps. I specify the first point and then I just need the opposite corner. First I type the x distance, it is negative, minus 250, because I'm drawing to the left. Then I press tab, and for the y distance, now it's positive, I type 400. Here you have the first rectangle. Now, which command I use for the internal outline? It's offset once more. So the offset distance is 20. I click on the rectangle and then inside it. For the next rectangle, I'm going to use the command mirror because the door is symmetric. So I type MI, I select my objects, press enter. Then I click on the middle point of this line and I will make a vertical mirror line. In erase source objects, I press no because I want to keep the original. Now, to draw the remaining windows, I'm going to use the command copy with the option array. You will see. I will type CO for activating the command. Then I will select all objects I want to copy. I press enter. I will select this base point. And now if you look to the command bar, you can see this option array. So I type A. Press enter. And here it says number of items to array. I type 3. And with this, I will triple the objects I selected. Now I will hover the pointer in this corner. I move it slightly up. And when I see the label extension, I type the distance from this point. I want the next frame. So when I use array, the distance between each object I multiplied is the same. To draw the top of the door detailing, I use line again. This time the first point will be at a distance of 100 from here. And for this line I will type 560, press enter. I press escape now. I press enter again to activate the previous command, which is line. I click in this midpoint to draw a temporary line with distance 200. And I did this because I know that the arc will intersect this point. Next, I will click in the arrow behind arc and choose 3 point. For the first point, I click here. the second there, and the last one I use the other extremity. Now I can delete this line as I don't need it anymore. And for the inner outline, I will use the command offset, but first I have to convert both objects in a polyline. It's very simple with the command join. I select the objects, press enter, and here you have a polyline. Now I can activate the command offset and specify for the distance 20. I select the polyline and I click inside it. Finally, it just remains the door knob. So first, I'm going to draw a line. I hover this endpoint and then move up. And I will write 1050. I did this because it is the distance from the center of the circle to the bottom of the door. I make a straight horizontal line till this frame. And then I click in the command circle. Choose the midpoint and draw a circle with the diameter of this line. Now that I have finished everything, I can now delete the lines that are not necessary. After finishing the door, I'm gonna show you how to draw the window. So, for the external border, I'm going to use the command rectangle. I will click with the mouse, for example here. And for the horizontal dimension, I will type 1500, then I press tab. And for the vertical one, I type 1200 and press enter. Then for the inner border of the frame, I can use offset, press enter. The offset distance is going to be the frame width, which is 50. I click in the rectangle and then inside it. Now, to draw the rest of the window, I can follow several procedures. I will show you a good one for users that work with the grid mode switched on. So first, I will activate the command line. I will go to this midpoint. And I draw the vertical line, which is in the middle of the window. Now I'm going to use the grid mode to draw a rectangle. I type REC, press enter. And now I know that the bottom left corner will be at these distances of 70. As the edge of each small rectangle measures 10, I need to count 7 squares, both vertical and horizontal, so it will be this point. For the opposite corner, it's the same, so it will be here. For the rectangle on the other side, I can use the command mirror. I click in the rectangle, and then I will draw a mirror line in the middle of the window. I press enter. And here it is, I have completed the window. Then, for making the selection easier, I'm going to convert both window and door to blocks. I will select the window first. Now, I click in that icon above for creating a block. I will choose a name, for example, window. I click OK. Now I have to select the base point, for example this one, and that's it. Then I will do the same for the door and click again in the icon or just typing with the keyboard B. Here I will write door for the name and click OK. I choose the base point. And that's it, all the door is now a single object. Finally, I need to copy the door and the window to the house. I will type CO and press enter. I select the door, press enter. Now I choose this base point. Then I have to hover in this corner and type the distance of 500 to place the door in its right position. Now I press escape. And then it's the turn of the window. So I'm going here. I activate copy again. I click in the window, press enter. Choose again this corner as a base point. Now I'm going to do the same. I hover here. I move right. And this time I have to type the distance of 2620. Now it's not finished because obviously I don't want the window on the floor. So I'm going to use move. Select the window. Press enter. Now I click in this base point. I drag it horizontally up and enter the distance which the window will be from the floor. Now I need to insert the second window. This time I will use another process with the command line. I hover in this endpoint. I enter the distance from this wall which the window is going to be 6300. And I will make here a vertical line with length 900. I press escape. And now I simply copy the first window. I select it. Press enter. Choose this as a base point and click in the end point of the line. Then just delete the line that's not necessary. So it's everything in this video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe the channel to watch the complete list of tutorials for beginners. Thank you very much and see you next time.